Hello, I'm Tim Adamson. In this presentation, I will describe our efforts designing social interactions with a humorous robot photographer. Comparing the two photos in this slide, it is clear that though they portray the same person, one is significantly better than the other. What can robot photographers do to capture quality portrait pictures? We study this question for a robot that operates in a university context. One idea is to advance technical aspects of robot photography and enable these machines with a notion of image quality. This has been the focus of most prior work in robot photography. For example, prior work has explored questions such as, how can robots take well-composed pictures of people, considering things such as the no middle rule, the rule of thirds, and the golden rule. Our research, however, explores the design space of the social interactions that a robot photographer has with individual photography subjects. We recognize the significant opportunity that this design space provides to complement the technical focus of previous work. Designing the social interactions of a robot photographer also comes with its own set of challenges. For one, you have the people involved, coming from a diverse set of personalities, backgrounds, and emotional states. Some people may love having their picture taken and being in front of a camera, while others may be shyer. People also come into a robot photography event with different goals in mind. Some may be intrigued by the robot and want to spend as much time with it as they can, while others may focus on getting a high-quality photo, or on taking a decent picture as quickly as possible. We used an iterative and human-centered design process to explore this design space. This process included informal interviews with professional photographers, building an initial prototype to engage users in social interactions, and an informative study to learn more about photography from people and from our robot. We then improved our robot prototype and the way it engaged users and conducted user tests. I will now briefly describe each of these steps and end with a summary of key design recommendations based on our design process. At the beginning of our research, we conducted informal interviews with three professional photographers. We interviewed them about their work and focused the conversation on the social aspects of portrait photography. During the interviews, the photographers mentioned two social aspects especially salient to a photography event. The first was what the photographer says to the subjects. This includes learning their name, getting to know a little bit about them, and saying encouraging things about the subject. The second salient aspect was how the photographer strives to make the subject feel comfortable and elicit genuine smiles. This idea came up when one of the photographers shared that one of the most important parts of his job is making his clients feel comfortable and at ease during the photography event. We also asked the photographers what the best way to learn more about the social aspects of photography would be going forward, and they all suggested shadowing a professional photographer in action. Before shadowing human photographers, we decided to first build an initial prototype of the robot, which we named Cheddar. Now when we had human photographers come into our lab to take pictures, they could also evaluate the prototype that we had made so far and provide us with feedback and suggestions. We made the prototype focusing on social interactions. All the hardware components of the robot were chosen with this goal in mind. We added a RealSense camera to our robot to identify faces and allow it to take the pictures. The platform had a screen face which displayed eyes. The eyes would blink and help give the robot greater animacy. The face was mounted on a 4-degree of freedom arm, which was used to enable moving the camera and keeping the photography subject's face in the image. After building the robot, we brought in professional and amateur photographers to have them take pictures of each other. We shadowed the human photographers and asked questions along the way. We then had the robot take pictures of the photographers. At the end of the study, we had a group discussion to gather additional feedback. We came away from the informative study with three main takeaways. Though Cheddar provided no direction, we saw that much of the human photography experience was driven by how the photographers directed the photography subjects in where to stand and how to pose. We also saw humor come up again with both professional and amateur photographers, who used it to make the subjects feel comfortable and enhance the interaction as a whole. Cheddar provided no feedback on the photos, and the professional photographers provided minimal feedback, which led the photography subjects to request that more feedback be provided in the future. We took these three points of feedback and decided to implement all of them on our robot. To allow our robot to direct the subjects, we added five numbers to the floor, as can be seen in the sketch on the right. We had the robot direct the subjects on where to stand by telling them which number to stand on top of. We also added humor to the robot. The humor was presented through one of four media formats, which included memes, GIFs, spoken phrases,
2, 4, 3, number,
and sounds. In total, we enabled the robot to deliver 13 different types of humor, each belonging to one of these four mediums. The humor was delivered right before the robot would take a picture in order to elicit smiles. To add feedback after taking a picture, we had Shutter look over to the monitor, which had the image taken, and then say something positive about the image. After making these modifications, we conducted user tests, in which we had 25 participants come into the lab to have their picture taken by Shutter. Shutter began the interaction with an introduction, asking the user if he or she would like to be photographed. It then proceeded to take 5 pictures, with humorous content being delivered in all the pictures but the first. In each picture event with humor, Shutter provided additional content during the countdown, right after the numbers 5, 3, and 1. This content was either one of the four humor types described before, or a no humor option. Following the countdown, Shutter took the picture, complimented the photo taken, and then directed the participant on where to stand next. From our design process and the results from the user tests, we learned important lessons that can benefit future robot photographers. I'll go briefly over a few of them now. Please see our paper for more details. The first lesson that we learned is that when adding humor, it is important to include a wide variety of content. When looking at users' self-reported smile response to the content delivered during the interaction, we found that humor content was generally more successful at eliciting spontaneous smiles than when no humor was provided. As you can see from the graph, humor content was 2 to 3 times more successful at eliciting spontaneous smiles. Worth noting, no one type of media was drastically better than the others. Because participants' preferences were diverse, it is important to include a variety of humor content in these interactions when attempting to elicit spontaneous smiles. We also discovered that when adding humor content to a human-robot interaction, the time required to deliver the content should be seen as a cost borne by those who don't find the content to be funny. Some participants smiled or laughed at all the humorous content, as can be seen in this short clip. While others never smiled even once. In order to automate spontaneous smile detection for robot photography, it is essential to consider human-robot interaction dynamics. As you can see here, people responded to Shutter with both posed and spontaneous smiles. Sometimes these smiles were easy to distinguish, and other times they were not. Traditionally, spontaneous smile detection algorithms are trained with videos that show people transitioning between neutral expressions and spontaneous smiles. But when it comes to detecting spontaneous smiles at photography events, it is important to consider posed smiles as well. Our work also reinforces a large body of research in HRI, which has identified the importance of robots acknowledging mistakes. Our robot always complimented photos, but when a picture did not turn out well, like the one seen here, the compliment was seen as disingenuous and forced. Thus, it is important for robot photographers to detect and acknowledge mistakes. First, we studied social interactions between individuals and our robot, but moving forward, we'll consider groups of users who may want to be photographed simultaneously. Second, we conducted our user tests in a laboratory setting. We are now starting to study interactions in the wild, allowing for a more diverse set of users and more complex environments. Third, the quality of the pictures taken by our robot was sometimes not as good as it could have been. Though our robot did use a centering composition when taking pictures, we plan to use more complex composition rules in the future to improve the quality of the photos taken. To summarize, our work showed the importance of studying social aspects of robot photography. In this context, humor is a key element which robots can employ to improve the experience. We hope others will be inspired by our work to continue research in this realm.